always could tease me. And I had this discussion with my work the other day. But 12 o'clock noon, if it's 12 a.m. or 12 p.m., always throws me. I literally do not understand why. Because 12:01 p.m. makes perfect sense to me that it's afternoon. But I'm like, what if it's, I always say 12 noon. I'm like, I don't want to confuse you. I am confused enough. Those are my two.
Well, think of high noon. High noon would be when the sun is up. So that would be 12 noon p.m.
I don't understand any of that. Like high noon p.m. what? I'm like, can I have my phone for 12:01 p.m.? I don't know. And stupid clubs and spades.
Oh, well, you got midnight. You remember their names this time.
Because you said them. Clovers and point of thing, arrow. Sorry. I feel like you guys know the drill of the warm-up. I haven't done anything. I can start doing it. We'll work into our legs. Swinging side to side. So really, you should only even need one weight today. So if you have heavier weights, you could use them. Don't have to. We'll switch legs. It's a song to start us off. Good. Now we'll switch to forward and backwards. And switch. Good, then we'll move into our hinges. Weights on the knife edge of our foot, our heels. And we think about pushing our butt to the back wall. On Tabata, I want us to try and do that full Tabata, so it's 4 minutes, 8 rounds. I'm gonna give you a little bit of freedom as far as picking what you want to do. And with that being said, and what I think I will do is pick two. And alternate because I feel like it breaks it up a lot better. So you can start thinking about that. Hope it's not our first card. I will shuffle so you guys don't think I'm playing some kind of prank on you.
I did see you shuffle.
From here, we're gonna move into our squats. So now we just sit back, pause at the bottom for a second. When you do about 8 of those, we're gonna go into our Spider-Man stretch. So, we hinge our hips, find that length in your hamstrings, walk ourselves out to a high plank. Right foot outside right hand. Option to drop your elbow to the big toe, but then you twist, open, feet go back, left foot comes up, open, hands walk back. We're doing that 4 total times. Trying to sink a little bit further into that lunge.
you can really open yourself up.
Trying to keep those palms on the ground as you're walking in and out. Good. Then when you're done with those,
you can take an extra second, stretch out anything that needs it while I explain our core exercises. So,
hearts. Is our yoga block pass. So we'll be on our back. We'll hold our yoga block in our hands. We pull ourselves up, pass it to our feet, reach back. So hands to feet and back to hands is one. So whatever number.
Then we have our plank pulled through mountain climbers.
So in our head plank, we'll pull opposite, put your hands down, one, one. Pull opposite, one, one. However many's on the cards. Clubs is gonna be a reverse lunge press. So this one will be two-sided and we're gonna do whatever, however many on every side. So with just holding your weight, we're gonna lunge back, come up. You have the option to just hold your knee up. That's gonna add difficulty, or you can stand. We hammer curl, press, back down. So it's just gonna look like this. Testing our balance, a little compound movement. So if it's six on the right, six on the left, and everyone loves frog hops. So you know we're starting our high plank, hands jump, our feet jump or step outside of our hands, butt sinks, we jump or step back. Little cardio there, little leg burn, okay? I think we'll try to do five cards at a time, see how we feel. If we need a little bit more break, then we'll do that. This is my little shuffling table now. Shuffle one more time because good things come in three. And a little of this. More. Okay, here we go. One, two, three, four. Okay, got a good mixture. I don't want this to blow away. We have five frog hops, I'll break this up. Nine plank pull through mountain climbers, 10 frog hops, nine yoga block can't do this all day. Nine yoga block passes, and then 10 reverse presses. So we're getting a lot of the big numbers out here at the beginning. So I'll cue you guys as we work through. But we're starting with the five frog hops, nine plank pull through mountain climbers, okay? Let's do this thing. Of course, the goal is to get through quickly. Keep your one weight close to you. Remember, the pull throughs, one rep is pulling each side in a mountain climber with each leg. Butt stays down.
With nine?
Yep. After that, 10 froggy hops right away. Butt stays down.
Number one is hands to feet. Laying flat between each pass. Then we have our reverse lunge to press. 10 each side here. Good lunge. If you choose the one leg route, find stability. Arms straight down as we lunge. Remember, we're doing 10 on each side here. Find lots of stability. Press with that shoulder. Curl with that bicep. And after you finish those, we have a moment of rest. We can call that first round done. Get a quick drink of water. I'll lay out these next five. Keep working. For what it's worth, I thought the yoga passes were the hardest in that. We get a lot of them out of the way here. So, that can either be very good or very bad. I think it's good. Let's get them done. Get through the rest of these. So, the five we've got on deck. 2 plank pull through mountain climbers. 5 yoga box. We can't do this one today because I can't say it. 5 yoga block. Okay, block. Block passes. 1 more block pass, so we'll do 6. 8 reverse lunge press each side. 6 block passes. So it's technically 2, 6, 8, 6. 2 mountain climber things, 6 block passes, 8 presses, 6 passes. Okay? Ready, let's go. We pull, pull, climb, climb. Pull, pull, climb, climb. Flip over, 6 passes. Hop up, 8, reverse lunge to press, each side here, curl, press, see if you can maybe get a good little clip going through these once you get comfortable with the movements. Good lunge depth each time, feet stay shoulder width apart. As we lunge, and then we end with 6 yoga And after those, another small recovery. So, we are kind of pushing right now. This, lots of times we don't follow exactly that HIIT workout because the purpose is bouts of obviously high intensity, which you can't do physically for. It really shouldn't be much longer than 45 seconds. But we're working more towards those intervals here, pushing for these five cards, which is ending up being 2-3 minutes, and then recovering a little bit longer. But with that being said, we're again knocking out a lot of yoga passes here. But I'm gonna switch it up so we stay good on our form. We have two reverse lunge presses, 10 yoga block passes, 10 reverse lunge presses, 7 plank mountain climbers, 8 yoga passes. So it's lunge, pass, lunge, climb, pass. All cue you as we go. But for now, we start with 2 reverse lunge presses into 10 lunges, okay? 10 passes. Oh my gosh, this is a Monday workout. Not Thursday. 2 lunges each side. 10 yoga block passes. 10 each side. Nice controlled movement. Focusing on each element of it. Thinking about core stability. You're pulling yourself upright with that core. Whoa, windy.
Is that wind?
Yeah. Then we have 7 plank pull-throughs. Pull, pull, climb, climb. Don't let your form break on these. And end with 8 passes. Push through it. I'm burning on these ones.
8.
Okay, another round, my friends. Done. We've got frog hops and mountain climbers that are just gonna pile up.
The yoga pass doesn't have to be close to giant. I'll say that.
We're doing 10 passes, 8 plank pull throughs, 10 passes, 7 reverse lunges, 3 passes. So it's pass, plank, pass, lunge, pass.
Pass, plank, pass, lunge, pass.
Yep. 10, 8, 10 to start us, okay? So, you can stay where you are. We've got 10 passes followed by 8 passes, I think. Yep. Grind this out. One rep at a time. Flip it on over. We double time those abs. 8 plank pull throughs with climbers. Those abs, they weren't already there. Should be el fuego. We turn back onto our back for 10 more passes. Again, one rep at a time here.
This is how many?
10 again. Take a break if you need. Those abs are burning. Seven lunges each side. Nice and controlled. Seven passes, 11
plunges.
11, 7, 11. So we have an ace and a jack on one side, a 5 and a 6 on the other.
Isn't there a fifth card?
Yeah, passes in the middle for 7.
Oh. Wait.
So,
11 lunges.
11 lunges.
Passes.
11 lunges.
11.
And we're going to get slapped in the face by these frog hops, which I guess is my own doing. You ask and you shall receive. Okay. Let's do this. 11 each side. 7 passes. 11 each side. Just stay consistent here. Don't let your form start to stumble as we get tired, especially doing lots of reps of the same too, it feels like. Extend between each pass. This is a 80s mix? This isn't very 80s.
No, it's not.
11 lunges again. Let's go. It happened, my friends. Okay. Here's what we've got. Our first tabata. So, I moved up to the beginning so we can all get through it together. 4 minutes, 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off, whatever you want to do. 8 frog hops. 10 lunges, 6 frog hops, 3 planks halters. Seems doable. Get your agua. Figure out what you're doing for the tabata. Remember, we've got 8 rounds this time. We're gonna try to do squat jacks. I hope I don't die. And then I'm gonna do just jumping jacks, squat jacks, jumping jacks. We're gonna go in 10 seconds here. Go again in 5, 3, 2, 1. For 20, come on. You know the goal here. Just push that heart rate. Relax. 1 minute done. 3 more to go. We have 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Come on. Focus on each 20 seconds. Nothing more. Relax. Woo! 10 seconds. Focus on your recovery. Let's go. Come on. Try to stay consistent on the reps of whatever you're doing. Relax. Halfway through. And we got this. 3, 2, 1. Come on, 20 seconds right here. That's all I'm asking for. Push. Keep going. Relax. Woo! Who loves me? Focus on recovery. We go in 3, 2, 1. Come on. Push. You got this. Relax. 1 more minute here. You got this. That's 40 seconds of work. 3, 2, 1. Come on. Best 20 seconds. Relax. Give 20 more seconds. That is it. Let's go. Let's go for a second. Last 20. Push it here. Three, two, one. Quick recovery. We're not treating this as a full recovery. You've got time for 3 to 5 deep breaths. Then we have 8 frog hops, 10 lunges, 6 frog hops, okay? And then we have 3 plank pull throughs. All right? 8 frog hops. Come on, get through them. Lunge, curl presses. 10 each side. 10 we got this. Just stay consistent here.
tap into that core as our arms and legs start to feel tired. Six frog hops, three of our plank pull-throughs. Come on. Stay with me. Then we recover. I'll give you guys a little bit longer of a recovery here. Our heart rate is probably pretty up there. Mine is for certain. This next round, we go 4 plank pull-throughs, 10 plank pull-throughs, 3 frog hops, 2 passes, 6 plank pull-throughs. So, you have the option here. I think it would be a benefit, I may try it this time, of doing your 14 pull-throughs on each side, followed by your 14 mountain climbers. That's gonna hold us more stable in our core for the plank. And then again, shoot that heart rate up for the mountain climbers. 3 frog hops right after that. 2 passes, 6 pass through climbers, okay?
Wait, so 14?
14, mm-hmm. 3 frog hops,
okay.
2 yoga passes, 6 climbers. Yes.
Okay.
I know I'm referring to everything as something. With that being said, let's go 14 pull throughs. Come on. Break this up how you want. Remember, each one is counting each side. So it's like 7, 7. You can do 7 pull throughs, 7 climbers, 7 pull throughs, 7 climbers if you want. Push through, come on.
How many of these?
6 passes to end that horrible, horrible round. We're almost there, you guys. Keep working. Pushing through this. We've got recovery. Get some water. Take some nice deep breaths.
we have three lunges. I don't know how we still have this, but we do. 10 yoga passes, 7 frog hops, 2 frog hops, 10 plank pull throughs. 3 lunges, 10 passes, 9 pull throughs, 10
hops. No,
frick, I messed up.
Lunge.
3 lunge, pass, hop, pull. So we have them all this time. Lunge, pass, hop, pull. I'll cue us. But we're going 3 lunges each side, 10 passes. Let's start there. Woo! I am working up a sweat today. Can tell you that much. 10 passes. Come on. Abs of steel for Thanksgiving. All the way through. Nine froggy hops. 10 pull throughs. Okay, so I underestimated it again. We have still more than one round to go. So I'm gonna make you guys a deal. We're gonna just finish with one round. All it's gonna require is 6 of everything. Chinker? So, we're going to do 6 yoga passes, 6 pull throughs, 6 lunges each side, 6 frog hops, and we're done. We got this. Our last round. If you want, you can do pass, pull, hop, so you're all on the ground, and end with the lunge, or start with the lunge and on the ground, or go up and down if you please, okay? Your goal is 6. Get through them. I don't care how, but we're doing it right here. Let's go. Push through this last round. Well, almost lost my block. Caught it with my feet. Challenge yourself here. This is your last, maybe, minute of work. I don't even know how long it's going to take. You got it. After that, we are done. And I mean it. Get some water. Stay on the ground if you're there. Really excellent work today. I'm just seeing what we would have had the next round. I saved us a joker, which I didn't. So we would have had it last, which would have been horrible. Get some water. Let's stretch you out. We can do it on the floor today. Start on our butt, soles of our feet together. Pull them in towards you. Think about lowering those knees to the ground, sitting up nice and tall while peeling your shoulders away from your ears. You can add in some head rolls here, maybe some nods yes, some nods no. Me too.
Here's a funny parody version.
We'll straighten both legs out. Nice big inhale. Exhale, reach towards your toes.
That I highly recommend everyone check out.
What's it called?
I think it's 2020 is a dumpster fire.
I'm gonna listen.
On YouTube.
Inhale and exhale, reach a little further. I don't know what the heck I was thinking. I said, if we have extra time, we'll stretch longer. Cross one leg over the other. First, I felt like last time it went a lot faster, but we had some more difficulties.
We had more compound stuff.
Yeah. Took more time. Pressing opposite elbow into the outside of the leg, causing you to twist. See that wall behind you? And untwist, go the other way.
My heart got up to 180.
That's good.
I don't need to keep that hydrated.
Unravel long neck. Formula, let's stretch our arms, pull one across the other. And switch. Good. We'll flip, make our way onto our back happily here. Let's start with the soles of our feet together again. Open up your knees in opposite directions. And try to relax here. Feel your low back sink into the mat. Release tension in your shoulders. Good, we'll zip our legs up, figure four, one of them. Cross that ankle over your legs, pull it in tight. Good. We're gonna pretzel that leg over, so think about your inner thigh squeezing, shoulders stay glued to the ground, and drop those legs to the side. Good, unravel out of that. Ugh. Untwist your legs, figure four the other way. Place that foot back on the ground, pretzel the other way, those inner thighs get glued together. Unravel out of that. Squeeze both your knees in tight, tight, tight to your chest. As tight as a ball as you can get your body into here. And in just the opposite, let's make ourselves as long as we can here for our final stretch. Push through your toes. Pull through your fingers. Take some deep breaths here. Three to four. And as you feel ready, we can roll over to one side and push ourselves up. Very good job tonight. That one kind of took me off guard. I hope you guys got a good workout. Have a great week in Georgia, and we'll see you on Monday, okay?